במגל עמוקוס רשחף וזיין. In Megali Amukos, it brings Ishavaya Ubeso, that a man came down to Mitzrayim, that refers to Ishavaya Ubeso Adnai, and his house is Adnai Bo, and they came. So Ishu Veso Bo, those three words, Sofitevos, Shin Vavav, Shilakach Bo Mitzrayma, that's how they came down to Mitzrayim, Sheyehye Yichud Shema Ubaruch Shem, that you should have this unity, this union between Shema and Baruch Shem, the higher and lower unity, or the in this case, Havaya and Adnai, Yishu Veso. So that's the Rashi Tevus, Shema, Shin Vavav is Shema, Ubaruch Vaed, like Shema and Baruch Shem, until Vaed. That is that the lower unity should be like the higher unity, like a rejoicing the groom with the bride. And in Emek HaMelech, the Pirush on the Zohar, so it brings from the verse, and these are the kings. Gamkin vav mosif chulu. There it says that the vav adds, so ve ele hamalachim, and these are the kings. It's adding to what's before. Mosif chulu, and so forth. Yishlomar, we can say, Yishu veso, what does it mean? So, a man and his house. So it says here, ve ele shmos. So it's adding on. You can say a man in his house, I know who Vishmo is Barak, that refers to him, and his name may be blessed, similar to the Megala Emukos. And therefore it explains in Zohar Yisro on the verse in his house, Shema de Kutchibrihu Ikibais, that the name of the Holy Basabihi is called house. And the Rebbe says on the bottom, Al Pasuk Bebeso, Kenirash Shitzarach Lios, Al Pasuk Bebesi, and it's not so clear which Pasuk this is referring to, Bebeso. So the Rebbe says, Mestama, it's referring to Bebesi, Vakavana, Shlikra, Venasati Lehem, Bebesi. And it's referring to the verse, and I gave to them in my house. The explanation on this Zohar from the Emek HaMelech. That it says, Shema de Kutcher Brichu Ikri Bais. Because a house is made out of stones, Shem Osios, which is the concept of letters, Vizo Inyan Hashem, Shu Osios, and that's the concept of the name, which is made out of letters, and therefore a bais is also a concept of a name, because a bais is letters. Mitzrayim b'Torah or Parshas Shmos b'Dibra Maschil Kol Dodi Perush Duhu Mitzar HaGaron. Now Mitzrayim, in the Maimer and Torah or in Kol Dodi, it says that this refers to the boundary of the neck, that it's the in between the heart and the mind in the and the concept of boundary. So going down to Mitzrayim is going down from the mind to the heart. Rabus Breishis Parshid Beis Al Pasuk Eile Todos Hashamayim V'Ha'aretz. Now in Medrash Rabba Breishis it says these are the offspring of the heavens and the earth. Bizchus Minivrau, in the merit of who were they created? Bizchus Eile Shmos B'nei Israel, in the merit of these are the names of the sons of Israel. Uberabos Vayakel, Parshamem Chestav, Kuf Samechalf. In Medrash Rabba Vayakel, Aldo Ve'ele Bizchus or Amudalad, it says Ve'ilu b'schus mihem omdim. It says, and these, in the merit of who are they standing? B'schus ela ha'edus ve'achukim ha'mishpatim. In the merit of these are the statutes and the laws and so forth. The testimonies and the statutes and the laws. So the names of Bnei Yisrael are standing because of the mitzvos. Both have the ele. Ha'inyan, mi, abba v'ima, bara ele, vav k'tzavos, the ziranpin. The concept is, on the verse, look up into the heavens and see who created these, mi bara ele. So mi refers to the mother and the father of Chochmen Bina, and the Rebbe says on the bottom, ha'inyan mi, rei l'kutei Torah, dibura maschile l'bekudei, perakei ve'od. So look in Likutei Torah Pekudei about this idea of Mibara Ela. So Ela's Gematria 36, which is 6 times 6, that's the Vav Ksavos. Hakluli Mishisha, that are included in 6. Ach Zeo Nimshach Miyuchar Achitzonis Chochmah Bina, but this is drawn down from the external union of wisdom and understanding of Chachmen Bina, Lahach Yosa Olamos, to enliven the world, Bibichinas Omdim. And the concept of standing, like B'schus Mihem Omdim, in the merit of who are they standing. Meaning to say, the regular divine flow just to sustain creation. B'schus minivrao, and the merit of who, of me are they created? Or in the merit of who are they created? B'schus elishmos b'nei Israel, and the merit of these are the sons, the names of the sons of Israel. Shemeorerim al yedei kriyas shma yichud pnimi, that we awaken through the reading of Shema, in inner union, a deeper union to Chochma Bina. And that's the concept I will give. I will give you travelers amongst the standers, like explained at length in Orah Torah for Hanukkah of the Maimonim of Mahalchim Bina Omdim. The different inyanim. Zeu inyan ela pekudei Mishkan. This is the concept of these are the Pikudei HaMishkan, Binyan Chai Vadam Lifkod Chulu, with the concept of a person's obligated to remember, a person's obligated to remember his wife before he travels. It's a concept of union, Lifkod. So El Pikudei HaMishkan is a concept of Pekida and union. That's a man and his house came down. They traveled, so that's why it says a man and his house, because when traveling, you have to have this union between a man and his wife. So Ishuveso Bo, so the man and his house came down. And the Rebbe says on the bottom, Binyan Chayev, in the concept of Chayev, Kinirat Sarklios, that it's better, the language should be better, just like the concept of the obligation and so forth. So again, back to this memra, it says, and these, in the merit of who are they standing, in the merit of these are the testimonies and so forth. Yishlomo, we can say, Alderach Mishkan Ha'edus, like the concept of the Mishkan of testimony, the tabernacle of testimony, Shlomayla Mimichinus Eile Pekudei HaMishkan, which is higher than the level of these, this is the Pekudei HaMishkan that we just said. So Mishkan Ha'edus is a next level, higher than that. Ki Edus Kenyan V'tavoi Ba'adi Adayim Chulu, because the concept of testimony is also like the language of Eidus is also like that you've came into your beauty of beauties and so forth, Lashon Edi, of decoration and jewelry and beauty. So Mishkan Eidus is the Mishkan of beauty, the dwelling place of beauty. So Mishkan is like a house, like a dwelling place. And Pekudei HaMishkan is the remembering the Mishkan, remembering the house. So in the case of Hashem, it's like a union of the masculine and feminine of Hashem. And then you have a higher level, Mishkan Eidus. Metavoi Ba'adi Adayim is a concept of you like Israel when they became beautiful. Ach Begalus Mitzrayim. But in the exile of Mitzrayim, Ubichinus Ve'ilashimos B'nei Israel Habay Mitzrayimah. It's the names of the sons of Israel coming down to Mitzrayim, with the concept of our signs we did not see and so forth. That you didn't have this level and this union until Yetzias Mitzrayim. And I guess the going out of the Mitzrayim HaGaron, like you brought before, which is the idea, he says here, of Yichud Kriya Shema. So the Pekida, Pekudei HaMishkan, is when you go down, so maybe that's the Yichud Chitzoni. And Mishkan HaEdus, maybe that's the Yichud Pnimi. So that would correspond with Mi Bara Eile and Bizchus Mi Am Omdim and Bizchus Mi Nivro Bizchus Shel Shemos Bnei Yisrael. But Bizchus Mi Am Omdim, he says Bizchus Eile HaEdus, so that corresponds with the first idea that they're standing, so that corresponds with the lower, the Yichud Chitzoni. But it says, Mitzchus Meim Omdim, Mitzchus Elah HaEdus. So that corresponds even with the first level. So maybe the Edus doesn't correspond with the Yichud Pnimi. At any rate, B'dibur HaMaskil, Olos Tamid Perush. Going further, it says that in the Mimer, the Velos Tamid, it explains Kishmo Yisbarichu Memalikol Almin, that his name may be blessed, refers to the divinity that fills all the world, Ushmo Gadol, and his great name Husoviv Kol Almin, that refers to the divinity that encompasses all the world, Vehu Bichinas Mekor HaTainugim. That's the concept of the source of pleasures, the Soviv Kolalmi. Like it says, with you is the source of life. And how is drawn down the flow of pleasure into the world? That's through Israel. So Imcha is its bottle to you. The Mekor Chaim is the source of life, the source of pleasures. And the way pleasure is drawn down into the world, that's through Israel. The to me your head, Kemuana Shama Mislabeshes Bemochin Shibirosh. Just like the soul is enclosed in the intellect, in the brains, in the head. Umisham is chalek lechol ramach evarim, and from there it divides into all 248 limbs. Veishtainuk nimshach b'ri'ah v'shmiya b'tamchulu, and you have a pleasure that's drawn down into sight and hearing and taste and so forth. Ach Yisrael mekablim al yedei Torah. So I guess the Neshama is revealed first into the head, so from there it brings out all the different pleasures of the head, and all the senses are a concept of experiencing different pleasures. So that's three Yisrael is the Hamshacha to do this. from Soviv Kolamin downwards into Panimi. Ach Yisrael Mekabli Malidea Torah, but Yisrael receives through the Torah Shichach Meila, which is the supernal wisdom. Shabarish is Giluya Tainug, that in the Torah, in wisdom, is the beginning of the revelation of pleasure. Michach Manim Shach Pemochin de Zeran Pinanakra Yisrael, and from Chach was drawn down the brains of Zah, which is called Israel. So Zerampin is called Israel, and then receives from the Torah of Chochmah Law, which is the source of, which is the revelation of pleasure, as it is in the soul. The Gilui Pnimi from the source of pleasure that's beyond the soul. Now the sons of Israel, that refers to Netzach and Hod. If Yisrael is Tiferes, then its sons are Netzach and Hod. And that it says on the bottom, Tikun Izor, Rish Tikun Memches, Tamiya Mitzvos, Vesifra Likutim, Rish Pashas, Kisis of Yod. Brings Makoros for this. Vzeu Ve'ilish Mos Bnei Yisrael. And this is what it says, and that these are the names of the sons of Israel, Bnei Israel, Shemos Benetzach Vahod. The names are in Netzach Vahod. Hem Tzvos, they are in Tzvos, like Kel Tzvos and Elkim Tzvos, Netzach and Hod, and so forth. Vechein Nemar Bnei Israel, yet so called Tzivos of Avaya. So to by the sons of Israel, it says, they came out all the Tzivos of Hashem. It's the same concept of this name, of the name of Bnei Israel, corresponds with Tzvos, so too. The sons of Israel, that came out, they're called Tzvos, they came, when we came out of Mitzrayim. K'mo shekasuv b'Torah or Parshas Bo, like it explains there, the difference between Tzivos Havaya and Havaya Tzvos. And the concept of Chana, who's the first one to say the concept of the name Tzvos, which is in the Old Mospia, and therefore it's only in mentioned in Nach. Habay Mitzrayim, they came down to Mitzrayim, Old Mospia Nikraim Kain. So that's what it says, that coming down to Mitzrayim, that the lower worlds of Briya Yetzira and Asiya are called Mitzrayim, because of the boundary and confinement of those worlds, and it's a descent for the purpose of elevation, that to this we merit Torah, which is supernal wisdom, that in the Torah shines his great name, the concept of the encompassing divinity. V'zeu meshubach mefora de'ad shmo gadol chulu. And this is what the pasuk says, praised and beautified forever and ever, his great name and so forth, like we say in Bar Shama. That refers to Soviv Kol Almin, that which encompasses all the worlds. Vayim b'Torah Or Dibor Maschil Ve'Lishmos B'nei Yisrael, and look in Torah Or on the verse that these are the names of the sons of Israel. U'Mashe Shaych L'Drushanal, and what has to do with this drush that we're talking about. I'm Asher Kazav Gemit Tzitzchem Eretz Mitzrayim. Look what it's brought about, the idea of like the days when you left the land of Mitzrayim, that what would be accomplished by going down to Mitzrayim, and spiritual ideas about that. I'm Asher Kazav Pasuk Shishi Mehima Malachos, and on the verse that there are 60 queens. I'm Asher Kazav Pasuk Muna Mitzparchulu Shemos Yikrar, and look what's brought on the verse, that he counts a number to the stars and so forth, and gives each one a name, concept of the names, and that Rebbe says on the bottom, Mashkos V'Pasuk Moneh, Reatze macht zedek al tehillim, nirfas b'shem yohel or, al pasuk se. That he explains the idea. V'hine b'magi l'arav b'is Yosef, reish pashas shmos. Now in Magid Meisharim, the Magid's speaking to the Rav, the Beis Yosef, in the beginning of Parshas Shmos, Zelashono, and this is what he says, V'alo b'Parshas Ada, Ikal Medak, that in this Parsha, we can scrutinize, Mai v'Ela Shmos Kulu, what are these, are the names and so forth, Hamanoyas Hon, b'Parshas Vayigash, Didn't the Torah already count them in Parshas Vayigash? Valraza de Milsa, but the secret of the matter of these words, Kivin de Nachsu Yisrael Mikvar Yas Yaakov, that once Yisrael went down to bury Yaakov. So skip the parentheses for now. It says Nachsa Shchinta Imhon. So the Shechina went down with him. V'stavku nishmosn di shivtaya b'svirin, and the souls of the Shvatim who attached themselves to the Sviros. So we're going to go back to the parentheses now. So it says, Kivin dinachsu Yisrael mikvar yas Yaakov, that once Yisrael went down to bury Yaakov, ayin mashikasa b'pirush rishon. Look what's brought an explanation. The first explanation, v'shechavti mavosai, of I will be buried with my fathers. That Yaakov makes Yosef promise that he will be buried with his fathers and so forth. And the Rebbe says on the bottom, v'perush rishon, soich iyun hakavana, this is now clear what he's referring to in the first perush. That's the union of Tiferes with Chesed and Gvura. So that's Shechavti im Avosai. So his fathers are Avraham and Yitzchak, which are Chesed and Gvura. And so if he's Shochiv with his fathers, that's Tiferes uniting with Chesed and Gvura. ובזוהר ויחיד אף ריש חבדל עמוד א' פירוש שזהו עניין שין שיש פה גימול רשין. And in Zohar ויחיד explains that this refers to the shin that has three heads, the avos, as opposed to the shin that has four heads on the tefillin, the imahos, the menasa b'chinas b'riya chatichon. And so with this, Tiferes becomes the middle pole and so forth. It goes upwards. It's a concept of elevation. So that's the Kfuras Yaakov. So that's why, by burying Yaakov, they achieved a greater spiritual height, and the Shechina came down with them. So when they first went down to Mitzrayim with Yaakov, it wasn't on the same level as after they buried Yaakov and went back to Mitzrayim. That when they buried Yaakov, they achieved a higher level, and the Shechina came down with them. And the souls of the neshamos were attached to the Sviros. And that's why it says, and these are the names of Bnei Israel. Musif al rishonos, that they add to the first ones. So in Vayigash, when they first came down with Yaakov. So that's one level, that's one counting, that's one mentioning of the names that went down. But ve'ele shemos b'nei Israel, and these are the names of the sons of Israel, adds to the previous counting something new. That's the Shechina that's now coming down with them, because they buried Yaakov, and you have this concept of elevation. L'mikvar Yaakov, la'dvaka lahon b'tiferes, to attach themselves with Tiferes. The Ramuz Bivav, that's hinted to in the Vav, that the Vav of Ve'ela corresponds with Tiferes of Zah. The Razin Dishimhon Talyan B'may the Amur Rabbanan, that the secret of the names is dependent upon what our sages said. Al Tikri Shamos Elashemos. Don't read Shamos, read Shamos, don't read destroyed, but read names. It says, Shasam Shamos Parets, that he gave desolation in the land. It says, don't read desolation, but read names. That's the end of the quote from the Magid Misharim that we need for our purposes. Explain this idea. We can explain his words according to what it says in Torah or Parshas Vayechi. Ata, an explanation of what it says, Yehuda, you, v'zel shono. And this is what it says in Torah or, hini ashvat yimim beiz b'chinas bin lamata l'mayla milamayla l'mata. Now the tribes, the two concepts, from below to above, and from above to below, alma denukva v'alma dedukhura. The world of the feminine and the world of the masculine. V'ayimi zev l'kutei Torah sof tibura maschil e'chaltzum eitchem. Look what's written in the Kutei Torah, the end of the Mimer. You should prepare from yourselves for battle. Ube biuri azor, parshas pamid, bar al ha-Mimer, daf kufyur chesum arbeiz, bepira shesham alo shvatim shivteka. And in Bamidbar, on the statement, in the explanation of that there were went up tribes, the tribes of Kar, Baramaz Sham, and in the Ramaz, and that's brought in the Biori Azor, the Shvatim Stam, Hin Osam Shalamata, that says, you have two levels then, you have Shvatim and Shiftei Kar. So Shvatim Stam, Hin Osam Shalamata, that when it just says tribes, that refers to the ones from below, Benukfa, and then the feminine aspect, like he says, that there's you have Alma de Nukva, Alma de Dechura, and Yud Beis Bakar de Bria, that refers to the 12 cattle of Bria underneath the Yam, underneath the sea, like in the Beis HaMikdash, so that underneath the Yam, that refers to the Shvatim as they are in the world of Bria. Vishivte Ka, and the tribes of Yudke, Hainu Shursham, Rishabit Tiferes, Adikon Lashono, that is as their root in Tiferes, I guess the Yud Beis Gvulei Alochson, as they are elevated into Atzilus and so forth. Adkan Lashono, that's the end of the quote from the Torah Or in Vayichi. Vehem Yud Beis Gvulei Alochson, the Zod Atzilus, and that refers to the 12 diagonals of Zerampin of Atzilus, the Shiftei Ka. Vayin Mashikos Mizeh B'dibur HaMaschil Machar Chodesh, Finif Karata, look what's brought in the Mimer. Tomorrow is the new moon and is the Chodesh, and you will be remembered. And the Rebbe says on the bottom, B'dibur HaMaschil Machar Chodesh Nidfas Pura Torah Al Sefer Breishis, and that was printed in Ora Torah on the Book of Breishis. Shem Yud Beis Tzidufei Avaya, that these 12 diagonals of Zav Atzilus are the 12 combinations of the name of Havaya. Hame'irim B'Yud Beis Rashi Chadashim, that shine in the 12 different Rosh Chodesh. Each Rosh Chodesh corresponds with a different combination of Shem Havaya and a different combination of the name Eya, and so forth. Like it's brought in Sidur Ari. So the Yud Beis Tzidufei Havaya, Me'irim B'Yud Beis Rashi Chadashim, Vayin Or B'Zor, Vayishlach Tav Kufayin Vav Aleph Kabe, Go Tresar. And it's brought in Zohar Vayishlach, it says, inside 12, these kasyan that are hidden, that are covered, the inun tresar nari, the afar samona dachya, that they are 12 rivers of persimmon oil, crushed persimmon oil or whatever. במקדש מלך, שם, שם יוד בייס גבולי אלוחסון, and in the Mikdash Melech there, that they are the 12, these 12 rivers are the 12 boundaries of diagonal, ha-me'irim min Tiferes Darich Anpin, which shine in, from Tiferes of Arich, ba-Abba ve-Ima, into Abba and Ima, v'nikra Shivtei Ka, and they're called the tribes of Ka. So here, when we talk about Tiferes, the Mikdash Melech says it's referring to Tiferes of Arich, and these rivers of not just oil, but a farsimona dachya, that refers to the flow from Tiferes of Arich into Ava. And similarly, this is implied in the Idras Nasa. An explanation of that you swore to our fathers from the days of old, meaning to say it's Hamshacha from beyond the Avos into the Avos, Shemibichinus Yud Gimel Tikune Dikna, the Arichan being that from the 13, the creations of the beard of Arich, Nishtal Shlu Yud Bez Shvatim, it draws down the 12 tribes to the Avos. Right, Masha calls it Belukutei Torah, Be'abir al Pasuk Rashi Amatos, and look what's brought in Likutei Torah, an explanation of the heads of the tribes. So with Perek Gimel, I guess it talks about the Shoresh of the Shvatim Lamaila. Ach, B'zor Chadash, Pashas Vayishlach Sham, Pirush Tresa Adis Kasyan, or maybe Zohari Chama, in Vayishlach, it explains there, the Tresa Adis Kasyan, this language of 12 that are covered, that are hidden, Hem Yud Beis Shvatim Al Yonim, this refers to the 12 supernal tribes, Haramuzim Besfiros, as they're hinted to in the Sfiros, Kinizkar Besaba, as it's brought in the Saba of Mishpatim Besaba. As it's explained in Saba, that Rabbi explains, Kinizkar Besaba, Ulai Kavanah L'Saba de Mishpatim, Zohar Chilik Beis Kuf Dalet Aleph, and the Rabbi says, that's what he says, that maybe the intention is to the Saba of Parshas Mishpatim, Ulai Gam Kin Milkutei Torah, Ulai Harizal, V'sifra Lukutim Parshas V'yetze. So he says, Kinizkar Besaba, Reuven, Bechesed Chulu, that Reuven corresponds with kindness and so forth, that the Shvatim correspond with the Sfiros, so the Zohar Chama, whatever, in Vayishlach, so he explains it a little different than we brought before from the Mikdash Melech, who says that it's from Tiferes of Arich, but you can also explain the Yud Beis Shvatim, that these Tres or these Kasyan are referring to the Sfiros themselves, that Reuven corresponds with Chesed and so forth, Vamar Diskasyan Chul, when it says that they're hidden, why does it specifically hidden? Lefishi Yeshud Bez Bokar Lamata Shen Diskalyan, because this is in juxtaposition to the 12 cattle below in the world of Bria and so forth, that are in a revealed state, the Merkavta Tata, Vikaran Nahare, and the Shvatim, they're called rivers, Al Shem Shinim Shachim Behem Hashpa, because it's drawn down to them in the flow, this supernal flow that's drawn from the supernal mother of Bina Hanikra Afarsimon, that Bina is called Afarsimon. Like it's mentioned in Zohar Truma, which is the end of the quote from the Zohar Chama. ובשיטה זו, דהזוהר חמה, דהזין חס מם, זוהר חמה מסתמה מפרש, המגיד לבייס יוסף, that's how the Magid explains it to the Beis Yosef, and according to that opinion, that the Shvatim are the Sfiros, the hidden Sfiros of Atsilus, the hidden level of the Shvatim as they are in Atsilus, coming from Bina, which is the concept of a farsimon. Now, an arousal from below, you have an arousal from above, that from the concept of Reuven, from below to above, Reuven, see your son, it's a concept of to gaze at the beauty of the king. That from this you have the strength of the love, the strong love. That's Reuven. Is his staklos of gazing at the beauty of the king, and from below to above, b'chinas pnei arye el hayamin. That's the face of the lion to the right side of arye os yosriya. Arye is the same letters as the word of sight, of riya, to see, to gaze at the king. Mayin mashakaz minyan arye b'dibur maskil v'kach min abab yado mincha. Al yidei zeh. Nimshach yisrus leila, and from this you draw down an arousal from above, milamayla lamata, from above to below. Vugili bichinas Reuven shilamayla behasfiros. That's a revelation of the concept of Reuven above in the sfiros. Tainu bichinas kira havai beonyi. The concept of Hashem has seen my troubles. Bichinas yiskarvus chulu, a concept of closeness to you. From above to below, kamo kinal yidei Shimon shilamata lamayla, so too through the service of the concept of Shimon from below to above, yod beis shvatim in the bria, as the tribes are in bria, meorer bechinas Shimon shebeatzilus chulu, so you awaken the concept of Shimon as it is in atzilus and so forth, shema havaya chulu, that Hashem has heard my and so forth, that Hashem has heard my difficulties from above to below. Shema vaikisnu anochi, and so forth. So Reuven and Shimon and Levi and so forth, they're all from below to above, from Bria, and that reveals an erusid leila of the Yud Beis Shvatim as they are in Atzilus. And the Rebbe says on the bottom, Shema Havaya, that Havaya has heard, Ad kanu lashana Torah Or, that's the end of the quote from the Torah Or. And look what's brought about the idea of dividing this, the Sea of Reeds, into 12 divisions. That refers to the idea of uniting the 12 tribes as they are in the world of Bria with their source in the world of Atzilus. That's the revealing the dry land into the sea, so the Yud Beis Bakar are below the Yam, and when you divide the land, Besocha Yam Bayabasha, so you're uniting the two concepts of the land and the sea. There's the Makor Natsilus, this Yud Beis division, the Yud Beis 12 concepts. And Rebbe says on the bottom. Look over there. And with this, we can understand the words of the Magid to the Beis Yosef. With the concept of these are the names of the sons of Israel, that these add. That in Parshas Shmos, as opposed to Vayigash, it's adding something new, a level of the Shechina coming down with them. So you have this. So now we've explained the concept of the lower Shvatim in Bria and the higher Shvatim in Atzilus. So Ve'ele Shmos, the second time, Kibbe Parshas Vayigash B'minyan, Ay Nefesh, Em Yud Beis Shvatim D'Nukva, that in the first counting in Vayigash of the 70 souls, that refers to the 12 tribes of the concept of Nukva, of the feminine aspect, Shem Ibriya, from the world of Bria, Vachakach Alidisha Olulik Boris Yaakov, and through this that they went up to Ber Yaakov, Kedabir Shrashi, Beparshas Vayechi, Like Rashi explains in Vayichi al Pasuk Vayisu also Banov, that it says that his sons lifted him or brought him up. Ukesidram lamasa machane shol digalim nikvo kan, that just like in the order of the camps of the flags, that they were established here. That's the machane. It's called the machane shchina. That were surrounding the Mishkan. When you do a shinyan adal de galim, they're all derech dalad machno samir kava, and it's known that this concept of the four flags, the four groups surrounding the Mishkan is like the four camps of the supernal merkava of the angels of the malachim. Bechinas v'achayos noses asakise, the concept of the chayos lift up the throne. So just like the chayos lift up the throne, what's chakuk on the throne is Yaakov, is the concept of Yaakov. So the chayos that lifting up the throne is a similar idea to lifting up Yaakov, perhaps. But the Shvatim did that as well. They lifted up Yaakov in the way of the machane shchina. V'gam l'idei habracha shebirichusam Yaakov. And also, bringing him up from Mitzrayim, you have this bracha from Yaakov. In Parshas Vayechi, ish asher kivir chaso birachosam, each one according to their bracha, he blessed them. Kivir chaso daika, each one according to their bracha, meaning kifi shor shobir beis gvuli alachshin shabatzilus, according to their source and the 12 diagonals of Atzilus. So each one got a hashpa from the mekor in Atzilus, kibir chaso, like his bracha, like his mekor. Lechin amar v'ulam echav hakaton yigdal mimenu, and that's why he said by Ephraim and Menashe, however his younger brother will be greater than him, kifi shorash Ephraim, meaning to say that he blessed him according to his source above, that the source of Ephraim shigavua yoser, which is higher, meaning to say he's not just choosing a bracha willy-nilly, but he's blessing them specifically according to their spiritual source. And therefore, through the blessing and through the elevation to bury Yaakov, then by their return to Mitzrayim, is drawn down with them also the 12 tribes as they are in Atzilus and Nikrashiv Deka, that are called the tribes of Ka, Idus Israel, a testimony to Israel, like he brought before, the concept of Edus is a higher idea than can be a second idea. And these are the Pikudia, the remembrances of the Mishkan of Edus, that the Mishkan of Edus is a second level, a higher level than Pikudia Mishkan, which Pikudia Mishkan is a concept of Yichud, like you brought before. Mishkan Edus, Edus Liakov, like is a higher level. Adi Adaim, maybe the Yichud Panimi. Zov Elishmos Bnei Israel by Mitzrayim, and this is what it says, that these are the names of the sons of Israel coming down to Mitzrayim. Ve'ela Mosif, that these, the word Ve'ela with a vav, adds Gamken Yud Beis, the 12 discussion that are hidden in from Atzilus, Ruvain Bechinas Kira Avaya, Ruvain that Havaya saw, Shimon Kishama Avaya, and Shimon is that Hashem heard, Levi Apam Yil Vechulu, and Levi is that now Hashem will be attached to me. Now, Leah said that now Yaakov will be attached to her, Shem Amshachos, Yudke, Shemos Tzerufi Avaya, their concept of drawing down Yudke, names of the combinations of the letters of Yudke Vavke, Atzilus of Atzilus, which correspond, like we said, with the months and the Shvatim, the Yud Beis Gvuli Alachson, So the Rebbe says on the bottom, Hatzilus ulai tzarech lius de'atzilus. It says de'atzilus. It's better to say, it would make more sense grammatically to say of Hatzilus is tzirufei avaya ha'atzilus. Should be better. Tzirufei avaya de'atzilus kulam bo'i mohem. They all came with them. Down to Mitzrayim, the concept of the Shekhinah, the concept of revelations of the Yud Bishvatim as they are in Atzilus, came down with them. The second time they were counted, their names were for Elishmos. Now going down to Mitzrayim, it's like the idea of those coming to plant the take root for of Yaakov. And afterwards, when going out of Mitzrayim, the splitting of the sea, he'iru behem mamush, it truly shined into them, this level. You had this. So when they went down to Mitzrayim, all these lights that came down with them, it's like the planting of the seed in potential. But when they actually left Mitzrayim, and then you had the splitting of the sea, so then you had this revelation in actuality. Hayud Bishvatim de Atzilus, so you, the 12 tribes of Atzilus, as the sea split into 12, and they call Shiftekar, and they called the Shvatim of Yudke. Ki betchilat b'yitzias Mitzrayim he'iru behem rak b'chinas makif, because in the beginning of going out of Mitzrayim, the beginning of Pesach, before the Shvi Shel Pesach and the splitting of the sea, you only have the concept of the an encompassing light. This level, this revelation in an encompassing way, like the concept of the mazel, the level of the higher level of the neshama saw, like it's brought in Likudei Torah, and through the splitting of the sea that it was torn into 12 tears, it shined into them in a true revelation, and that's what the end of the pasuk is of Habayim Yashish Yaakov, that it sprouts and flowers Yisrael, you have the flowering, the sprouting and the flowering from the planting of going down to Mitzrayim, to the concept of the Yitzias Mitzrayim and the splitting of the sea.